in this video, we'll be taking you through our step-by-step guide to painting an Ultramarines Brutalis Dreadnought in less than 10 paints. The aim of this guide is to get reinforcements on the battlefield quickly and easily, ready to storm towards the enemy, breaking lines and striking down their forces. If you're new to painting, you can check out the Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos to learn all about it. The series is linked in the description box below. The paints you'll need to follow along with this guide are listed on screen now. So the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model, and for this we've chosen to use Macrag Blue. Doing this will mean that all our armour panels are already base coated for us, saving us loads of time in the long run. We'll also need to have a pot of Macrag Blue to hand, just in case we need to do any tidying up later on. The first areas of the miniature we're going to paint are the silver areas, and for these we're going to be using Lead Belcher. We're going to start off with a medium base brush just to help us get that paint on nice and quickly. When it comes to doing a second coat, we're going to switch to a small base brush just to help us be a little bit neater. Lead Belcher is a base paint, so we need to thin it down with a little bit of water before we apply it. Then we build it up on the miniature with a couple of layers of paint. Doing this makes sure we avoid any texture building up on the model and gives us that really nice smooth finish. Models of this size might seem a little bit daunting, but don't worry. Split the model into sections and work around it systematically. This will make sure you don't miss anything and means it feels more achievable. Whenever you've used a metallic paint, it's always a good idea to change that paint water before using non-metallics. This will stop any shiny flakes getting into your non-shiny paints. Once all that silver is fully dry, we're going to be painting the black areas using Abaddon Black. So stick with that small base brush to carefully paint the arm sockets and any other black details, including the gun casings. Again, this is quite a big stage of the guide, but just take your time and make sure you get all of those black areas. Now you might have noticed that on the box art, the Mechanica symbol at the back of the miniature is black and white. But just for now, we're just going to paint it black and we'll paint the white in later. With that done, we're going to switch back to metallics and use Retributor Armor to paint the gold areas. There aren't too many of these areas, so it won't take us quite as long. Stick with that small base brush and apply a couple of layers of paint to get that nice finish. And don't forget to just change that paint water after you've finished with your metallics. Now we're going to go back to that Mechanicus symbol at the back of the miniature, and we're going to use Corax White to paint the white areas. Make sure you thin down the paint, then we're just going to faintly mark out the line down the middle. Once we're happy with the positioning of this, we can then go back and paint it in properly. Again, it'll need a couple of layers. If you make any mistakes, just go back in with some Abaddon Black and just tidy back up. The next thing we're going to do is paint the red areas using Mephiston Red. So this is some of the pipes and lenses. It doesn't matter too much which of these you decide to pick out, it's really up to you. You might have noticed we've switched to a small layer brush for these more detailed areas. This gives us more control, which helps us be neater. Mephiston Red's a really nice punchy red, and this will really stand out on the model. Some of these areas are quite tricky to reach, so don't worry if you do get any on that blue, just go back in with some Macrag Blue and tidy it back up. The most important thing is that we get the red on all the relevant details. With the red finished, we're now going to pick out the yellow areas using Aerial Yellow. Again, we're going to stick with that small layer brush to help us be neat here. You'll see here that the lamp is quite an intricate detail, so don't worry if you get any yellow on those silver areas. We're just going to go back in and tidy up with Lead Belcher after. And with that, all our base coats are finished. The next thing we're going to do is move on to some shading. And we're going to start off with Basilicanum Grey. This is a contrast paint, but when we thin it down, it works really well as a shade too. We'll be using this to start off with on the silver and the red areas. So put some on your palette and add a little bit of water just to thin it down slightly. Then we'll be applying it all over the silver areas. We don't need to be too neat here, just focus on getting into all those tricky to reach areas. We'll also be applying this over the Mechanica symbol at the back of the miniature. Just make sure you've really thinned that paint down, as we want this to be quite subtle over the white. If you find you've accidentally applied it too heavily over that white, just go back in with some Corax White to tidy it back up. Even though these are quite large areas, we're going to stick with that small base brush just for more control and again to help us be neat. When you're applying shades over large areas like these, it's always good to work in small sections. Doing this means the paint won't dry out too quickly, which means we get a really nice consistent finish. We're also going to use Basilicanum Grey to do something called a recess shade. For this, we'll be using a small layer brush as we need to be quite neat here. We'll be using Basilicanum Grey in the same consistency as we were before, so just with a little bit of water to thin it down slightly. Recess shading means dropping the shade carefully into all those panel lines and around the rivets. This can be quite time consuming as we want to be as neat as we can here. But this will be a better effect than an all over wash. If we apply the wash all over those flat panels, there aren't any recesses for it to seep into. This means it'll sit on top of the panels and won't give us that nice smooth finish we're after. Basilicanum Grey is a little more pigmented than Norn Oil, which is why we've chosen to use it for this. We really want to emphasise those dark recesses. And with all that done, we're now going to move on to shading the gold. And for this, we're going to use Reikland Flesh Shade. We'll be taking this straight from the pot and applying it over those gold areas. You'll see that it gives a really nice rich tone to that gold. We'll also be using this to shade the yellow areas, but for this we've just added some water to thin it down slightly. This means the effect will be more subtle and won't overpower that yellow. With those shades done, you can absolutely leave your miniature looking as awesome as it currently does. It's more than ready to charge into enemy lines and take down Xenos filth. However, if you want to take your paint job to the next level, stick with us. The next stage of this guide covers edge highlighting, and we'll be using Khalgar Blue for this. Now, highlighting the edges of all those armor panels might look a little bit daunting, and it will take time, but the key is to be quite selective about which areas you choose to highlight. It's really up to you how much or how little of this you do. You'll find that even if you just highlight some of the more prominent edges, this will really draw the eye to the model on the battlefield. With a model as large as this, it's quite easy to miss areas. So work your way around the model, checking each area as you go. Models like this really lend themselves to edge highlighting because you've got lots of hard edges on all those armor panels. And for this, we can use the edge of our brush to get the effect really quickly. And if you make any mistakes, don't worry, just tidy up with some thinned down Macrag Blue. And there we are, your Brutalis Dreadnought is finished, ready to smash through enemy lines. You can see that our model is now based, and if you'd like to learn more about basing, check out our Citadel Colour Painting Essentials video all about it. Well, we hope you've enjoyed the video. We'll see you next time. Bye!